Golf denies bud marketing, a Maine brewery starts canning, and Green Flash dies. We've got the perfect beer to pair with all these headlines, but more on that in a moment. I'm Slamaroo Sly. This is The Chug.
You're watching Beer and Loathing's Chug, the best source for beer stories that may or may not have pissed you off last week. These are the stories that got shuffled under the rug or have been covered to death on the internet by everyone else and needs their final send-off, Beer and Loathing style. We stir up that outrage one last time so you can get good and pissed off and move on to the new shit that'll piss you off this week.
Welcome to the 80th iteration of this nonsense. First up in words we'll bleep that aren't fuck news, the Masters banned the phrase... Yes, that was bleeped, because fuck Bud's marketing and fuck that phrase. Please note that we aren't bleeping fuck right now. I would rather say fuck for the whole world to hear a million times over before saying that stupid, meaningless marketing catchphrase. Now, if you used that phrase at the Masters, you got ejected. No word on whether or not you could say fuck at the Masters, but we hope you can, because that's gotta be the number one word uttered by anyone who plays golf, pro or not. Meanwhile, and everyone is talking about this shit, so I guess we will too. News, Allagash Brewing in Maine is canning their beer. Great job, guys. No one would shut up about it. Here in Colorado, people would be like... We do a lot of cans, that's why. Now lastly, and I'll take things swept under the rug for 500, Alex. News, Green Flash Brewing has been foreclosed on and all assets, including Alpine Beer, sold to WCIPA LLC. So while everyone is jerking off over cans, barely anyone is acknowledging an entire company that was dead set on going to 50 states, defaulting on loans, and having all their shit sold to some shady-sounding LLC that clearly stands for West Coast IPA? Bueller? Nothing? If they'd been bought by AB or Coors, everyone would be losing their goddamn minds because it's big beer taking over. Where are the bubble bursters now? Am I being trolled? All right. I need to cool off for a hot second, so let's go live to me and Brian Hangryman from Focus on the Beers for a hazy IPA chug off at our mutual friend Brewing in Denver.
3, 2, 1.
Good race, gentlemen. Keep up that good work, Mr. Hangryman, focusing on the beer. It is all about the beer. Well, thanks for watching the chug. Share with your friends and we'll be eternally grateful. Comment with beer requests or stories we need to cover. This week's stories unequivocally pair with Green Flash. Now, our tasting panel decided that the West Coast IPA was the clear winner. Its notes of used to be better and pioneer style that lost its way along with hefty bitterness complements the shame and resentment of a storied brewery going for greatness, going for the gusto, falling short, and suddenly just going down the hatch, much like this IPA is about to go down my hatch. So come back next week, find out what pissed you off this week. Ooh.